It's a place where drivers from across the world love to race.
This is the best way that we can move forward. I mean, we come here, we learn. The bar has been set by this place now. I mean, for all future tracks, future and even the existing ones. I mean, this place has set the bar pretty high, and I mean, I hope and pray that in the years to come, maybe 5 years, we don't just have 3 tracks, but maybe even 15 tracks. You know, with the way motorsport is going, I mean, there were huge crowds here today. Now they're all kind of gone because it's so hot. But even though they sat through the afternoon heat, so that really goes to show you that the people are interested in motorsport. They really like it. It's exciting. And I mean, being at the booth is just brilliant. What a beautiful track, and love driving here, and can't wait to be back for the final round, which is in December, second week.
It's a 5-odd-kilometer track, and you have a lot of margin for error here, because the more the corners, the more the error margin is there. Then again, you have the straights where one can slipstream, so there won't be much gap between cars. Coimbatore is a narrower track. There are many, it's more about cornering. It's a slower track, but a more technical track. This is a fast track, so you need to push your car, brake late, and exit faster. Slipstream is one really great thing we can do on this track. So all you see on the straights is one car behind the other car behind the other, and you do not know whether it's going to dive on your outside or on your inside. Basically inside, but you do not know. So a lot of slipstreams happening. First lap is the most critical lap. If you make it to the first lap, you will finish the race. If you do not, then you will definitely, because everyone wants to jump in C1. The main technique for racing driver is to jump on the inside.
We caught up with multiple national championship winner, the current leader in the FB02 championship, and one of the country's best race drivers, Vishnu Prasad, to take us through one lap of the Bhuj circuit. And this is what he had to say.
C1 is a mid corner, mid to high speed corner. BMW, you take it in second gear, then you go all the way uphill. There's a big elevation change. There's a tight hairpin. Again, you from fourth you go down to two. And then comes the 1.2 long kilometer straight, which is the most fun part of the circuit. At the end of the straight, I think we're doing about 210 kilometers per hour. At the end of the straight, we brake, come down to about 60-70. Second gear corner, another hairpin. And then the double left, then the flowing sequence of corners start. There's a double left, C4 and C5, where you enter it in fourth, and then you go to third. And then comes the fast chicane. You're almost flat in fourth gear. Then the long parabola, it's a long corner, it just keep goes on and on and on. And that's one of the most important corners. You can lose up to a second easily. It's pretty important to nail that corner. And it's a fourth gear corner. Comes again, it's a downhill, the big elevation change again. Then you come up to the fast chicane again, the fast left into the fast right, which is almost flat again in the BMW, it's fourth gear. Then you come up to the penultimate corner, which is again climbs uphill. It's completely blind. You can't see the corner at all. You just have to start turning blindly and then hope you hit the apex. And then again, it's a downhill left to the final corner, which is again a second gear corner. And yeah, that's your lap.
JK Tyres association with Indian motorsport began 3 decades ago, when the company took a conscious decision to lay down a long-term and sustained approach to promote Indian motorsport.
Back when we took this constructive decision that we are going to invest on motorsport, and the company got the whole package together. I was from the motorsport background, I was inducted in. We were from an era of rallying, and it was after 7 successive years that we realized that if you need to give a fillip to the sport, if you want the sport to be looked at by common man, you need to go back to the drawing board, you need to go back to a stadium sport. And that's how in 1997, we got this whole package together of racing, where we had a 800cc powered single-seater racing car, and we used to have Maruti S-Teams as our saloon category. This is how we started, with very, very humble background. And as they say, rest is history.
And over these 3 decades, through the efforts of its motorsport division, the company has been associated with events in all forms of motorsport in India. From the JK Tyre Rally of Coimbatore, which is part of the National Rally Championship, to the TSD format JK Tyre Hornbill Rally held annually in Nagaland, and most recently to the JK Tyre Arunachal Festival of Speed, held for the first time in 2014 in the town of Dirang in Arunachal Pradesh. In the racing format, JK Tyre has the distinction of hosting the JK Tyre Racing Championship, which is now in its 17th year, and the JK Tyre Rotax Max National Karting Championship, which has been going strong since the past decade and is currently in its 11th year.
Although there were some big boys who were kind of ready to take this game, but if you wanted the sport to find its feet, so we needed to get go-karting into India. And that was the same time in 97 December that we opened our first four-stroke karting center. And this whole program then evolved on year-on-year basis. And in 2000, we also had our first karting championship. So even the karting program now is in its 14th year. And this racing program is in its 17th, actually 18th year, because first year we ran it as a contender to the championship. So it's been a long, long journey.
In all these years, it has been JK Motorsport's endeavor to break away from the elitist image that the sport has and to make motorsport in India more affordable, at the same time to ensure that it is at par with international operating standards and promoting Indian motorsport talent and making India a force to be reckoned with in the world of international motorsport.
You see, today we are in the bestest of situation because I don't think we should look at this championship or any other scenario. We should look at Indian scenario. And we should be very proud that we have this fantastic entry level 100% Indian car, and as I said, is the cheapest form of racing that is available in the world. So come to the Indian driver. He has now got a program. He starts from four-stroke karting in the backyard of his town, graduates to two-stroke, graduates to LGB, graduates to the higher levels. So I would say if a kid has it in him, he can train himself in this country and actually now launch his career from F3 and above when he goes abroad, which was not the scenario earlier.
Driving a race car is a very tricky affair, but driving different race cars on the same race weekend is even more complicated. It requires a level of skill very few have, and even fewer people have the skills to win in all formats. After having a brilliant run in the 2013 racing season, where he won in all formats that he raced, multiple national champion and one of the country's most talented race drivers, Vishnu Prasad, is at it again. But he knows it's not going to be easy. Day 2 of round 3 of the 17th JK Tyre Racing Championship began with the LGB Formula 4 race. Vishnu Prasad was on the grid in Miko Racing colours, in the indigenously built Formula LGB cars. His toughest challenger, Dark Dawn Racing's Diljit Shaji, not only had a faster car, but more experience. Shaji started from P6 on the grid, but drove spectacularly to slowly make his way up the grid. The aggressive Chitesh Mandodi was ahead of Shaji, but lacked his usual pace. Shaji, being in the faster car, overtook the young driver to slot himself right behind Dark Dawn teammate Sudarshan Rao Karwar. Rao also succumbed to pressure from Shaji, as did rookie Rahul Rangaswamy. After climbing up to P2, Shaji had Prasad in his sights. But Prasad was pulling away. A tough fight ensued between Shaji and Prasad over the next few laps.
I started off 6th and I was able to, get two guys on the start itself, to the C2. Then in the back straight, I was able to use, I had a plan to follow Chitesh, but it didn't work out because I think his car is a little bit slow. Then I saw that Vishnu is flying away from me, so I just want to catch him up because he's fighting for the championship. So my team is, he was second in the championship as of now, but right now Vishnu is, coming up. So I just need to, save my championship points. So I just want to catch up with Vishnu. So like within 3 laps, I think I caught up with him. Then that's good.
In the end, Shaji's experience prevailed and he took the checkered flag only 0.32 seconds ahead of Prasad, which speaks volumes about the skill of both the drivers and how closely they fought. Rookie Rahul Rangaswamy held his position and came in third.
The finish line, I think he had some problem with the overheating or something. And even my car, I am struggling with the handling. So I was holding him even the last corner, because the last corner, that's what the thing which makes the change, you know. So I just don't want to him to overtake, so I was keeping the, you know, maximum what I can. So which kind, there was like, I came first like for a half car length. If he didn't had something like a car problem, maybe it'll be it'll end up in a photo finish.
Like I mentioned, we all realized a little too late that we were letting the leaders run away, that is Chitesh and Diljit. But unfortunately, race 3 works on reverse grid. So Diljit and Chitesh started right at the back, with Vishnu and Sandeep starting in on pole and second. Throughout the race, this was the best battle, because all of us had realized not to let the leaders run away, so no one was being desperate, so there was six-way fighting between me, Diljit, Chitesh, Vishnu, and towards the end still Vishnu and Diljit managed to break away, because it's always going to happen when six cars are fighting, two of them are always going to get away, and that's what happened. But me, Raghul and Chitesh fought it out till the end, and in the end Raghul came out on top, but I guess he cut a few corners, and I've filed a complaint. Let's see what happens. I finished in fourth.
From the tad underwhelming driving seat of the LGB, it was time for Vishnu Prasad to shift to the FB02 cockpit. The versatile driver has been adjusting to three different cockpits this racing season. He is driving in the JK Racing India Series, the Formula LGB4, and in the Cinemax category at the JK Tyre FMSCI National Rotax Max Karting Championship. And he's in line for the title in all three championships, all three of which he won in the 2013 season.
As the Formula BMW cars get ready to race, it looks like it's going to be a tough, tough fight. Defending national champion Vishnu Prasad has to fight with the likes of Aditya Patel, Rahil Nurani, Nayan Chatterjee and Krishna Raj Mahadik. Things will get heated up, and they'll do so as fast as the cars.
After an uneventful start to the FB02 race, Akhil Rabindra fell behind midway before a blisteringly fast Vishnu caught up with the pack and pushed to the front. Vishnu overtook former Polo R Cup driver Rahil Nurani with relative ease to take the lead. Rabindra tried to make moves on Nurani but was denied. Vishnu raced to another checkered flag ahead of the pack and another race win. Nurani was second and Rabindra came in third.
The race 2, basically, we started off with P3. Luckily for me, I had a brilliant start, was good off the line, was in third itself. Later on, we had a guest driver, Aditya Patel. He passed me, I think, on lap 5. And so I sort of tried to follow him for a few laps. One or two laps later, we had caught the guy ahead. Now, Aditya went past him very easily, but obviously because he knew that Aditya's a guest and stuff, so he let him go very easily. Whereas when I came up behind him, obviously he gave me a really tough time. For the, like, almost 3 laps I was behind him just trying to pass him. So I mean, in the end, I think it was the last lap on the third last corner or something where I finally was able to pass Akhil and claim second spot. And I mean, it felt really good considering it was the first weekend for me back here at the booth in these single-seater cars, first time for me in these cars. I'm so happy to have, out of 3 races, been on the podium for 2.
The third and final race of the FB02 category was an all-out Vishnu Prasad show. Vishnu put in a dominating and stellar performance and raced ahead of the field from the very start. He bagged a sizable lead and ran away from the pack without anyone else coming close. Vishnu took the checkered flag. Rabindra held his place but finished 7.454 seconds behind Prasad. Anand Shanmugam came in third.
Today was a very good day for BMW. I mean, I won both the races, especially the second one. I loved the second one. Started in the reverse grid, started sixth and kept moving up the field, and by lap 4 I was leading, and then after that I put in lap after lap and pulled away a big lead. It was a really fun race coming through the field, and I have a good distance in the championship between me and Akhil, and hopefully that should do for last round. When I started sixth, and Akhil was starting fourth, so my main aim was actually before the race to finish ahead of Akhil. And no matter where it be, 5th, 6th, 1, 2, 3. But eventually, you know, I got in 3rd place and I knew the win was in sight. I had only Akhil and Anand ahead of me, and I also knew I had the pace, so I kept pushing. And Akhil made a small mistake coming out of the last corner, so I was able to get a slipstream and put a past him in C1. And then after that, it was only Anand, but Akhil wouldn't go away. He kept putting pressure from behind, so I had to look in my mirrors as well as focus in the front. Anand, I had a little more pace than Anand this weekend, and I managed to pass him in lap 4, and after that I just kept pulling away little by little.
As you can see, they're getting better and better and better. The only way I could catch them is to become a little more consistent. Okay, I found a way to drive a handicap car, but I was just more consistent. And then I was more precise about making my moves, and that comes with experience, you know. So these guys just have to get a little more bold now. They need to get more consistent in the race. Okay, you have two or three at the top who are there, you know. We're close, but if, for example, if we had to start at the same place, they would suffer the same thing. So definitely from the top to the bottom of the grid, I'd say consistency and to find a little more boldness while overtaking your race, find the right, pick your right spots, I'd say. It's a long race, 20 minutes, so to just take your time.
The Polo R Cup race was up next. And Polish guest driver Dylan Pereira led from pole to flag to clinch the race win with relative ease. Karminder Pal Singh had a bit of a fight with Karthik Thorani, but prevailed in the end and came in second. Thorani was third, and that brought the championship closer between him and Karminder Pal Singh.
And for today's race, I think it went the way I really wanted to. From sixth, I came to second. So it was a very big push for me. And I really needed points, and now as Lee couldn't finish the race, he has a problem with his car, so I'm leading the championship. And as I said, for me right now, maximum points is the key, and I will be sticking to it. So yeah, really looking forward for the next race.
Race 3, I was in pole, and I had a good start, and I was able to pull away from the back really well. I had about 6 or 7 seconds by the end of lap 4 or 5. And then I think there was an incident in the mid-pack and that called the safety car out.
Going into the C1, a lot of cars bunched up. I came out through very clean, but the car on my left side spun. So he just came in front of me and I dashed into him. And then the car behind me also dashed into me. So it was like a pileup that happened in the first corner itself.
After the restart, coming into C1, I brake and downshift twice, but the gearbox goes into neutral. So I was pretty much stationary on the track for about 6 seconds, and that allowed 5 cars to go by me. And I had to really, really slog it out with Anandit and Gosha to get back on the podium. It could have been a very easy win with the lead that I had and the pace that I had, because I was consistently clocking 229s. But I mean, that's what motorsport is, and you just have to take it with a smile, and next round will be good.
The JK Tyre Superbike Series is an attempt to promote beta class bike racing in the country. The grid of riders is a mix of both amateur and professional racers, coached by Indian superbike racer Dilip Rogers. This makes us very, very happy and excited. And as you can see from the crowd's response, they echo the sentiment.
The JK Superbikes Cup was the main attraction of this race weekend. And seeing the fire-breathing liter-class race rockets take to the track in a racing format for the first time in India was something all motorsports enthusiasts were looking forward to. The riders were all amateurs brought together by the efforts of Ikjot Singh Basin and ace superbike racer Dilip Rogers, who helped the riders get track ready in a racing format.
Yeah, it's good always to meet Dilip, because he always tells us how to give the gas, how to take the corners, how to take apex, everything. He always helps us out, and today I asked him that it's a crucial day today, so I'm really tense, so what to do? He said, be calm and just put one first, second and third gear first, and then go down, take a second gear and then turn.
A loud cheer went up from the crowd as the deafening sounds of the de-restricted mufflers of the superbikes echoed through the BIC grandstand. And as the bikes lined up to take start, there was a palpable nervousness on the grid. And then, the race began. After a hard-fought and highly competitive race which saw the superbikes go flat out at breakneck speeds, Kulwant Singh Monty, who executed some brilliant and clean racing maneuvers, took the checkered flag ahead of the field, clocking a time of 16 minutes 55.538 seconds. He was followed to the podium by Gurminder Singh and Bhupinder Singh in second and third position respectively. And both the riders rode a brilliant race and held their own on a grid of some very skilled riders from across the country.
I didn't take a very good start because it little jumped. So I couldn't take a very good start, but on the first corner, I somehow managed to control the bike. And I was, I think, second at the first corner. I took the corner really well. And then after that, I just went away and I didn't see anything. I was just looking to the track.